Hi everyone, I'm Arielle, an educator at the Harvard Museums of Science and Culture. Today I'm going to show you how to make this sundial that really works. You've probably noticed that shadows cast by the sun change throughout the day. Sundials like this one use those changing shadows to tell the time. The collection of historical scientific instruments here at Harvard has an amazing collection of sundials. Before I show you how to make this one, let's learn more about sundials and how they work from an expert.
Hi, my name is Sarah Schechner, and I'm the curator of Harvard's collection of historical scientific instruments. Today we're going to talk about sundials. Did you know that before people checked the time on their cell phones or wore wristwatches, they carried time in their pockets? Sure, you say, I've heard of pocket watches. But I am talking about before pocket watches, when people carried sundials in their pokes, as Shakespeare put it. These pokey portable dials came in many shapes and sizes. They were made of wood, paper, brass, silver, ivory, and bone. The largest collection of them in North America is at Harvard in the collection of historical scientific instruments. We have about 565 portable sundials. Our examples date from the 1500s to the 1900s, but portable sundials go back to the ancient world. The great variety allows us to compare one to another. They tell us a lot about the people who made and used them, how rich and poor they were, what kind of work they did, what their religious faith was, and where they lived and traveled. Now let's talk about the sun and you and your shadow. You probably know that the sun rises in the east, arcs across the southern sky, reaching its highest point at noon, and then sets in the west. We can divide this into two basic motions. The sun goes up and down, and it is moving from east to west. Paired with the sun, your shadow grows shorter and longer and changes direction from west to east during the day. These changes point to the time. On a sundial, the shadow is cast by a part called the gnomon. The gnomon often looks like a triangular sail, but it can take many shapes and even be a person. You could be the gnomon. This cute pocket sundial was a trendsetter in its day. Invented by Michael Butterfield, an English instrument maker working in Paris from 1663, the sundial is distinguished by a triangular gnomon whose angle can be adjusted for the user's latitude. The beak of an adorable bird serves as the pointer on the latitude scale. The hour plate is usually octagonal, as you see here, and has four nested hour scales, each one for a different latitude. To pick the best one, the user only has to turn the sundial over to see a directory of cities and their latitudes on the bottom side. A large magnetic compass on the top helps to orient the sundial in the right direction. Butterfield-type sundials were so fashionable in Paris that many instrument makers made them, and some even counterfeited them. This particular example was made by Nicolas Bion in Paris about 1700.
This sundial is similar to the one Sarah just showed us. It uses this gnomon here to cast a shadow. To make this sundial, you'll need scissors, glue, tape, and a template like this. You can find templates of different latitudes on our website, which is listed in the description of this video. So here, I cut out my sundial. I used heavy paper for this, but regular copy paper will work too. Now I'm going to fold my sundial in half along this line between the two HMSC logos. Next, I'm going to fold these sections up along the line that says True North. Next, put some glue in this section here. F- fold these two pieces together and stand your sundial up. And there is our completed sundial. Let's take it outside and set it up. To set up our sundial, we need to point the gnomon in the direction of true north. The sundial Sarah showed us had a compass built right in, but I used the compass app on my phone. North is this way, so I'm going to turn my sundial so that the gnomon points like this. Now let's look to see where the gnomon has cast its shadow. There it is. It's almost 11 o'clock. This sundial shows local solar time, which means it might be a few minutes off from the time on your watch. Thanks for joining us to learn about sundials. If you enjoyed this activity, you can find more on the HMSC Connect's Kids and Families Activities page. Bye, everyone!